gospel newspaper has a contest every summer where thousands of people write in and vote for their favorite group, favorite song, favorite singer. I want you to know, favorite musician, this little peanut right here has been voted the number one piano player for the past 3 years, Anthony Berger! Been voted the number one musician for the past 5 years in our business, Anthony Berger! This young man has been voted gospel music's number one musician for the past 7 years in a row.
The young man that plays the piano for the Kingsmen is, we think, the greatest gospel piano player that's ever lived. He's been voted gospel music's number one musician 10 straight years in a row. He's won virtually every award there is to win in Southern gospel music. Make him welcome, ladies and gentlemen.
My name's Anthony Berger. It's good to be back here in Orlando, Florida, having a great time. I started playing the piano at the age of 3. But when I was 8 months old, I was learning how to walk in a walker in my mom and dad's house. And one of the wheels got stuck in a floor furnace. And a walker turned over with me in it. Burnt both of my hands. Was carried on a pillow for a year. Had 3 medicated baths a day for a year. Doctors said I'd never move my hands. I still can't move him. He does.
I can't let this fella here pass without just saying this boy's name's Berger. He was with us for 17 of the best years in my life. And he was also with us for 17 of the worst years of my life. It would not be a Kingsmen presentation without Anthony Berger. I'd kind of like to have a special hand for him, if you would.
But I want to talk about this little fella right here a minute. Bless his little heart. Him can't hardly play the piano. I remember seeing Anthony the first time at the quartet convention. I read about him in the Singing News and I hated him immediately. The Kingsmen were my favorite group, and don't tell George and Glenn that, I had a picture of everything that was important in my life is my girlfriend, my dog, my mom and dad, and the Kingsmen. And I read in the Singing News that Nick Bruno was leaving, and I thought, here's my shot. And then I read that Anthony Berger got the job. Saw him the next year at the quartet convention, never seen anybody play exactly like Anthony. He's one of the all-time greats, and I want you to give him the round of applause that he deserves, Anthony Berger.
One of my favorite stories of Anthony is, and Lewis told me this, and Anthony told me this, when he was first with the Kingsmen there a short time. And if you knew Anthony, and all of us knew him and watched him for years and years and years, and just an incredible, incredible showman. And he was with the Kingsmen. It was a small stage. And he had his piano right by, and there was an orchestra pit there. And he did this long run. And, you know, Anthony, he would always play it up. You know, when it was a 10, he would make it an 11, just for a good laugh. But this night, he made it a 15. And he went off the piano and fell and went up in the orchestra pit with his piano bench coming down on top of him. And within just a few seconds, here come the piano bench flying back up on top. And here come these little bitty fingers trying to get back up. And he come climbing back up, and of course Anthony made it a part of the show, took a bow, and got a standing ovation.
Somebody. Somebody asked Coach Dean Smith what he taught. What basketball techniques did he teach to Michael Jordan? And he said, you don't teach Michael Jordan much about basketball. He said, I hope I taught him something about life. Because genius is genius. And that word is overused a lot. But if we ever had a genius in our field, this young man was one of the most talented young geniuses I think I've ever heard.
I was told that at age 3, Anthony walked up to the church piano and played the old rugged cross. And so his mother promptly found a piano teacher for him. And the rest is history. 2 years later, when he was 5 years old, he went to the Shattuck Conservatory of Music in Chattanooga and began the training that would teach him to perform with the passion and the excellence that became his trademark. I think Anthony would be pleased for us to use the symbol of his wounded hands today to memorialize his life and work. I believe this because he lived his life in Christian service, and he knew what the story of redemption was all about. So this is the greatest tribute then today that we pay to Anthony, to take to heart the lesson that his all too short life has taught us, that God uses wounded souls to make wonderful music, and that he heals all of our souls' diseases if we will just place them in the wounded hands of Anthony's master and friend. The peace of God be with you all. Amen.